Previously, fans had theorized that Eve and Lilith were the same entity in Hazbin Hotel, something that was supported by the Kabbalistic interpretation of the mythological figures. But in the season finale, Lucifer revealed that he had interacted with not just Lilith, but Adam's second wife as well, with the clear implication that they had relations. Is it possible that Charlie is not the daughter of Lilith, but actually the daughter of Eve? My name is Impcut. Hit that subscribe button because today I learned that only 68% of our viewers are subscribed, and I know you can't resist the temptation to get that up to 69. Now in the show, Charlie has a storybook that, while probably not 100% true, does seem to allude to something that really happened in the history of the Helliverse. Long ago, there was heaven, but there apparently was no hell. Here, angels like the Seraphim and the Ophanim all lived together. Together, they decided to make life, but Lucifer was not involved because his ideas were considered very dangerous. Lucifer claims that he is given humans free will, symbolized in Charlie's story by the act of giving Eve the fruit of forbidden knowledge. However, Lilith already had the ability to disobey Adam and leave him, so free will here doesn't seem to mean what it usually means. Because this is a children's fairy tale that Charlie is reading, it probably is a more clean version of what really happened, and to many people, the same is true about the actual Garden of Eden story. The real-life Bible has no Lilith as the first wife to Adam, but instead, Eve is created from the side of Adam because he cannot find a partner among the other creations of God. Together, Adam and his wife tend to the garden, until one day, the snake tricks them both into eating the fruit of forbidden knowledge, with a focus on Eve being the one to converse with the serpent, and Adam even blaming Eve when God questions why he would eat the fruit himself. God curses the serpent as well as Eve, while also claiming that there will be enmity between their two lines, with the serpent biting at Eve's heel and Eve's descendant crushing the serpent's head. Now, in the Bible itself, the serpent is not presented as an angel like Lucifer, but he became well understood to be a symbol for the entire tribe of fallen angels within Jewish mythology. In the Bible, specifically in the story of Noah's Ark, these figures are referred to as the sons of God, who themselves were known to be the fathers of the Nephilim, Hebrew for fallen ones. The term Sons of God was used to refer to the Council of Angels subservient to God elsewhere in the Bible, and in the later Book of Enoch, their lore was elaborated on. This book, found among the Dead Sea Scrolls, explains that the Sons of God were divine beings who were sent down to give humans knowledge and guide them, but who rebelled against God by taking human wives and giving them knowledge they were not ready for. It is through the expanded narrative that ties into the story of Noah's Ark that we can see that the serpent from the Garden of Eden was just a symbol to unify the tradition that was initially seen as an entire tribe that we now call fallen angels. The serpent represents the fallen angels, and thus Eve represents all of the women who married the fallen angels and gave birth to the race of Nephilim or giants. And thus, when Lucifer in the show indicates that he slept not just with Lilith but with Eve as well, he's hinting at the same idea that Eve was made pregnant by the serpent in the Garden of Eden, and that this is what the act of eating the fruit of forbidden knowledge really was about. The evidence for this came from within the Bible itself. Earlier in this video, I explained how God foretold that the serpent of the seed and the serpent of Eve would be in constant battle with each other. However, we don't hear about Eve's descendants being in battle with the serpent later in Genesis or in the rest of the Bible. Instead, in the very next chapter, we see the clash of two lines of men, the first being the line of Cain and the second being the line of Seth, who had to be born to replace Abel as Cain had killed Abel. The reason for the disconnect between the character symbols from Eden to the genealogies of Cain and Seth is because these stories were written at different times. Originally, Cain and Abel were likely written as a story separate from other existing myths, and seemed to be an attempt to take a tradition that would have been portrayed by lesser gods in other mythologies and portray them as actually human. Cain would have been conceived as representing the same tribe of beings that the serpent and fallen angels both represented, without being written with those particular stories or symbols in mind. At some point, a compilation of these various stories would be made. These stories, like many ancient texts, were actually meant to be read out loud and more like poems or even songs. And with that information, scholars have been able to see where the original parts of the story end and where new additions begin, with the new additions often being something that connects it to the stories before or after it. Since the Garden of Eden narrative focused more so on a creation of humans and the status quo of life on Earth, it would be chosen to be the first story in human history when compiling all of these different myths together, with Cain and Abel's story being rewritten so that they were the children of Adam and Eve, despite those two characters having little significance to the actual narrative and probably not being involved in the earliest drafts of it. This is the key to understanding the overarching narrative of not just the Old Testament itself, but the entire Bible, simply tracing the changes of names of certain symbols from one story to the next to reveal the greater plot thread. All of this could mean that Lucifer got Eve pregnant and, like in the biblical stories, created a line of beings that actually existed on the earth. However, others have been theorizing that Lucifer's joke about sex with Eve is setting up the big reveal that Charlie was her daughter all along. Considering that Lilith was willing to abandon Lucifer and Charlie to go chill in heaven on a beach and is now apparently going to sabotage her daughter's hotel in order to maintain that, I think it's very possible that Charlie is not Lilith's real daughter and that this is something Lilith began to resent over hundreds or thousands of years. Now, deep in our real life past, when Hasbin Hotel was still just a pilot and even Hell of a Boss was just getting started, there was one note about a livestream on the Hasbin Hotel wiki that indicated that VisiPop and or some other crew member was asked about the possibility of Cain and Abel being involved in the show, with there being cryptic hints that something sketchy did go on there, but I can't find that source anymore, and even if I did, it is rather outdated. So while I can't take it as absolute evidence of anything going on with Cain and Abel, it would indicate that VisiPop definitely had some sort of plan for Cain and Abel, at least thematically, and I can't think of a better way for those characters to get involved than for them to be tied to a character like Charlie. Now, the fallout for this kind of reveal would be absolutely devastating to Charlie in particular. She has mended her relationship with her father, and that might ultimately be what makes everything feel okay in the end, as Lucifer is definitely her father, and Lilith, as much as Charlie may want to love her, seems to have tried to sabotage their relationship. As an adult, Charlie believed her father wanted nothing to do with her, and Lilith was seen keeping Charlie away from Lucifer even as a child. Playing it off, it would seem like Lucifer needed more alone time without her. That being said, the levels of betrayal she would feel would be pretty intense as well, and I can't imagine her not being heartbroken by it. Just finding out Vaggy had kept an immense secret like being an angel from her sent Charlie spiraling, and knowing that her mother is not just actually not her mother, but also abandoning her might be too much for Charlie to handle. Now, as cool as this is as a theory, I'm not 100% sold on it, if for no reason other than Charlie really seems to take after her mother Lilith. Eve, as only the second woman ever, may not have looked that different from Lilith, so the fact that Charlie is closer in height to her mother than her short father, and looks like her when her hair isn't all bundled up, may not mean anything at all. And Eve may essentially look just like Lilith, but with a different hairstyle. To be honest, I find it more interesting in terms of Lilith's betrayal if she is the real mother of Charlie, because so far she seems pretty horrible to be abandoning her in hell for a beach in heaven. But what do you think? And if you think it too often, do other people hear it too? Let me know the extent of your psychic abilities in the comments down below, or think them so often that I can just hear it myself. And don't forget to watch the little animation we made of Sonic the Hedgehog doing a battle against Mario. You'll probably hate me for recommending it to you and end up leaving a hate comment like this one guy did. See you guys there.